Where can you win $32,000 on the turn of a card right here on Card Shark? And now, the host of Card Shark, Bill Rafferty.
Thank you. Thank you all very much. Thank you. A nice group. Look at you out there. Thank you. Thank you all. Welcome everybody to Card Shots. You know that right here, you're going to win a fortune on the turn of a single card. And we have a guarantee that our players get a fair deal. Here they come right now. Here is Lacey Pemberton and she's out with you.
Nice looking group. No, they're not standing up yet. We can work on them a little bit maybe later during the break.
Ladies, deal out those cards. Let's get going right now. We're going to be playing our game quite shortly. We have Susanna dealing out the red cards on the top for our returning champion, and Lacey's dealing out the blue cards on the bottom. They're going to be played for our challenger, which means it's time in the show right now. Let's meet our card sharks.
Hello, Terri.
Hi, Bill.
Good to have you back with us.
Yeah,
you are a new champion.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Sure. I'm Terri Carlson. I'm from San Diego. I'm a housewife. I'm a mother of two children, and I'm a licensed daycare provider.
Licensed daycare. Now,
yes.
How much did you win yesterday?
$1,400.
$1,400, yes. Exactly. A lot of money. That's a great day's work.
Great.
Terrific.
That's fine.
Let's say hello to Clay, your challenger. Hello, Clay.
Hello. How are you doing?
I'm fine, sir. How are you?
Terrific. My name is Clay Marquardt. I'm a 28-year-old bachelor out of Pasadena, California. I'm assistant manager of a major brokerage house in Los Angeles, and I have hobbies ranging from surfing to marathon running.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you look like you're really in good shape. Welcome. Welcome to you. Each of you has put your cards backstage.
Okay.
Let's get right on with the game right now. First question. Oh, this is my favorite part of the show. We have 10 gentlemen from junior high school here with us right now. Come on up, fellas.
Are you the biggest kicker when they run up?
Listen, these guys have been with us all week. They have been helping us with our questions for our contestants here. They've also been sharing some loot. These guys won a couple of dollars here while they were here. Wonderful group of fellas. Give them a nice round of applause. They worked very hard this week.
Good group of guys. All right, Terri, here's the first question for you.
Before the show, we asked these 10 boys, this is nice. Have you ever fallen in love? How many of these 10 boys have fallen in love?
Oh, fallen in love? Maybe they had a crush, but I don't think they've ever really fallen in love. But I think that they think that they have fallen in love, and I think that's going to be about seven.
About seven?
I think it's going to be
about
seven.
That's a high number. You're saying
seven?
Yes,
I do.
What do you think? Play higher or lower, sir?
Well, I was at that age myself, and I remember thinking I had fallen in love quite a few times, but being afraid to admit it an awful lot. So I'm going to go with a number lower than that.
You're going to go lower than seven.
All right.
This is interesting. I want to watch this one myself. The actual number of these boys who have fallen in love is... It is seven, right on the button. It isn't lower, it's seven. You guys are making money here. Here we go. Because you hit it right on the button, you win $100.
Yes!
That's for you.
Yes!
And you guys know what the story is, right?
Yeah!
Yeah. You get the split, $100 a month. That's the third time this week. Sit down and count your money. Go ahead. Terrific. Sit down, fellas. Okay, Terri, we go to the board right now. Here's your card. You can change it if you like. It's a six.
Change that card, please.
What does that six become? A ten.
Ooh, never free.
Lower than a ten.
Ooh.
That means that Clay, he gets a free shot at the cards right now. Let's take a look at the base card. You have to play from this base card, Clay. You know that. We've got a two.
Right.
Way to go.
I'll play it higher off
He's
that two.
He's going higher than a two. We've got a jack.
I'll play lower off the jack.
Lower than a jack. We've got a seven.
I'm going to freeze on the seven.
He's right here. He's going to freeze right there and protect his position. Let's go on to our second question right now, and this one is for Clay. If he gets this question right, he jumps back in, changes that seven. Anybody's guess after that. We surveyed 100 single women, and we asked them, have you ever said no to a man's advances just because he was so sure of himself? How many single women said they had?
I think I've had quite a few women say no to me because I was a little too sure of myself. wanted to put me down and squelch that ego a little bit. So I think that there are going to be a fair number of people who said that. I'm going to go with 69.
69. 69 out of 100. What do you think, Terri, higher or lower?
I think that it's just going to be a very tad lower. I think that if a woman likes the man and likes his advances, I don't know. It depends on how bad he wants the man.
All right. You're going a little bit lower.
Just a tad lower.
I've been out of this marketplace for
just
so long, I don't even have an opinion. The actual number of single women who have said no because a man was so sure of himself is 76. It isn't lower. It's higher.
I think I'll change that seven.
Come on, get some cards up here. We've got an eight.
Oh, that's a lot better. I'll tell you what. I'll go higher. I feel a higher card.
Can we go higher than what's right in the middle? You can go
higher. I'll go higher.
You're going higher than an eight. We've got a 10. He knows
I'm going to go for it. I'm going to go lower than the 10.
Lower than the 10.
Way. Right.
Lower than wins the 10. Game one. Lower than a 10. An eight. We got a winner.
Got a winner. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You just won $100. First player to win two games, they go on to the money cards. We know how much money's available there. We'll be right back with our second game right after this. Welcome back. Here we go. We're getting ready to start game two. Susanna's already dealt out the cards. Our champion, Terri, a little bit of pressure going on right now. Clay's got one game on his side of the board. She's got to win this game to get this into a tie if she hopes to get to those money cards. Here is our first question. We surveyed 100 commercial airline pilots, and we asked them, this is for you, Terri, have you ever had a near collision with another plane? How many pilots admitted they have had, or they have almost had a collision?
I really don't think that that's going to be very high. I think that they're very cautious, and if they were to have a close call with an airplane, I do not think they want to stake their reputation and say that they did. I think that that's going to be very low, probably around 22.
22 out of 100. Clay, what do you think, sir?
22 is a tough number, but I think that an awful lot of pilots spent a lot of their time in the Navy or the Air Force or had to put in an awful lot of hours to become a commercial airline pilot. With all those hours in the air around those crowded airports and off an aircraft carrier, I think a lot did have it. So I'm going to say a higher number than 22.
Well, now, I want you to bear now, how many pilots admitted, these are commercial airline pilots, how many pilots admitted they have almost had a collision? You're still going with that same number?
I'm still going with that same number.
You're still going higher. Okay. The actual number of pilots who have had a near collision with another plane is 56. It is higher. Can't do it. Okay, here we go, Clay. Take a look at the base card. Change it if you like. We've got a queen.
I like that little lady. I'm going to go lower from there.
You're going to go lower than a queen. We've got only two chances of that happening, and there it was. Okay, Terri, you have a free shot at the cards right now. You must play off this card. An ace.
Lower
than an ace. A four.
Higher
than a four. A king. Lower than a king. A three.
Higher.
If she's right, she ties it up. It is. Whoa. Wait on
time.
All right. Congratulations, Terri. You've got $100 on your side of the board. You just tied up the match. We go on to the tiebreaker right now. And because it is the tiebreaker, we play it with three cards and a maximum of three questions. And Susanna and Lacey are setting it up right now. Let's get the next question over to you. Clay, your turn, sir. We surveyed 100 married men, and we asked them, would you be willing to wear a beeper so your wife could reach you at any time? How many married men would be willing to wear a beeper?
I don't think that you're going to find very many men who are willing to put on a beeper so their wife can get them. You have to spend a lot of time with your wife, and you have to love your wife, but I don't think she has the right to call you anytime she wants to. I'm going to think that's a very low number. I'll go with 21.
You're going 21?
Right.
21. Would you, Terri, want your husband to wear a beeper?
He doesn't have to wear a beeper because I call him about 100 times a day. So he's always available there. But I don't think my husband will wear a beeper just so I can get a hold of him. I think that that's just going to be very little less.
Just a little less. Okay, you're going lower. The actual number of married men who would be willing to wear a beeper is 40. It isn't lower. It's higher. Significantly higher. All right. Wait. Here's your card, sir. Take a look at it. A queen.
Right. It's that little lady again. I'll try her lower one more time.
Lower than a queen. A six.
I got to play it, and I'm going to swing it back higher again.
If he's right, higher than a six would be the game and the match. If not, Terri gets a free shot at the cards. Higher than a six. It is.
New check. All right, Clay. Way to play the cards. Terri. What can I say? You don't know how $1,500 virtually got you so much. We'll see you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Come here, Clay. Good job, sir. Good job. When we come back, our new champion is going to take a shot at the money cards. If he plays them right, he could win $32,000. I think you want to wait around for that. We'll be right back. Champion right here. Clay's ready to play the money cards. Lady's going to be dealing out the cards right now. Let me tell you how to play the money cards. Clay, the money you've won is yours to keep. We're going to start you out with some new money to bet with. We're going to give you $200. Start you out on that bottom line. You bet your way across the board. You call high and low. Then when we get to the second line, we're going to give you $400 additional betting money. You bet your way across that line. Minimum bets are $50, except when you get to the big bet at the top. There you must wager at least half your dollars. We'll give you an opportunity to change one card per line from one of the spare cards that Lacey is dealing out right now. That's really all there is to it. It's up to you to make thousands of dollars. You ready to do it?
I'm all set.
Okay, let's give Clay $200, please. Yeah. Here we go, Clay. Let's look at this base card right now, sir. A deuce. Way to go. Way to go. $200.
Higher.
$200 higher on the deuce. You realize if it's another deuce, it's what we call a push. No win, no loss.
I'll say.
$200 higher. A queen, way to go, 400.
I said 350 lower.
350 lower than a queen. A nine, $750.
Change that nine, please.
Tell me which one you want.
Oh, I'd like number three.
Number three, thank you, Lacey. Let's get some cards up here for Clay. That nine now becomes a deuce.
$750. Let's do the bundle higher.
Higher than a deuce, $750 on a turn of the card. We got a five, way to go, $1,500. Bring the five up here. We now add $400 now.
I'm gonna keep that.
You got $1,900 playing off the five.
I'm gonna keep that five and I'm gonna bet $1,000 higher.
$1,000 higher than a five.
Right.
You ever bet $1,000 on a card?
Never.
All right, way to go, Clay. $1,000 higher. No! $900 playing off a good card.
I'll bet $850 higher off the
850 three. Higher than a three. A three, it's a push. You're still in the same shape, $900.
On my side, I got up the whole thing to 900 higher.
900 higher than a
right.
Three. Yeah! $1,800. Playing off the eight.
We'll change that card, Bill.
Change the card, please. Which
one? We'll go with number one, the top card there.
Okay,
top
number one
right
card.
There.
Come on, give me a good card here.
That's good to us.
We've got an eight. You must wager at least $900 on
it. I am going to bet just half the money, and I'm going to bet it's going to go higher.
Right in the middle.
Right.
This is a tough call. You're wagering half higher.
Correct.
We're talking $900 higher than an eight. No! But listen, you've done well.
$900.
You've got $900 in your pocket, which is more than you came in with. You've done well.
Absolutely.
You'll be all right. When we come back, he's going to meet in her challenger. We'll be right back after this. Brilliant. Welcome back. Here we are with our champion, Clay. He's got $1,100 in his pocket. Wants to get a better run at those money cards, but before he goes to those money cards again, he's got to face a new challenger. Come on out here, Katrina. Hello, Katrina.
Hi, Bill. How are
you? Good to see you. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hi, my name is Katrina Washington, and I'm from the Windy City, Chicago, Illinois, where I'm a paralegal and the proud mother of two beautiful daughters.
You do? Oh, you're paralegal, and what are the girls' ages? Tell me about that.
3 and 11, April and Amber.
You're a busy lady. You
yes,
keep yourself
I am.
Occupied. You've cut your cards backstage?
Yes, I have.
I wish you both good luck. We've got
Thank
Susanna
you.
Already dealing out the cards, ready to start our first game. First question always goes to our champ. Clay, you ready, sir?
I'm ready.
We surveyed 100 bachelors and we asked them, if you notice that an attractive woman is wearing a wedding ring, do you still ask her for a date? It's kind of personal for you there, Clay. How many bachelors said they do ask a woman for a date, even if she is wearing a wedding ring?
I'm a bachelor. I qualify to answer this question. If I see an attractive girl, I do look down at that left-hand second finger and see if she's married or not. And if she is, I do not ask her for a date.
Okay.
So I think it's going to be a very low number. I'm going to go with 19.
19 out of 100. How do you want to answer this, Katrina? Higher or lower?
I think that number is going to be a little bit higher because nowadays, men, other men, they just don't want to take out other women that are already married because they fear for their husbands.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's one
right,
of the main reasons
they want to be stay alive.
So you're going to go a little higher on this.
Yes.
A little higher than 19. The actual number of bachelors who ask a woman for a date, even if she is wearing a wedding ring, is 20. It is a little higher. Lady knows the numbers. Ready to go, Katrina. Take a look at this card. You can change it if you like, Katrina. A 7.
Yes, I would like to change.
That 7 now becomes a 3.
Higher.
3. A 5.
Higher
than a 5. A 10.
Freeze.
Good choice as we pull this over here. Katrina, she freezes and protects her position. She keeps Clay away from those cards. She knows how to play the game. Now, here come my friends again. Let's bring back our 10 gentlemen from junior high school. Here they are. Guys are making money and having a good time. All right, Katrina, this question is for you. Before the show, we asked these 10 young guys, if you could meet either Michael Jackson or Ronald Reagan, would you rather meet Michael Jackson? How many of these 10 boys would rather meet Michael Jackson?
Oh, the way things are today, they would love to meet Michael Jackson. Everybody's into movies and the stars, the rock stars, and they want to meet a celebrity. Why not? And Michael Jackson's a bit more appealing to this age group, and I'm going to say that number is 8.
8?
Yes.
All right, Clay, higher or lower, sir?
I'm in absolute agreement that Michael Jackson is probably more appealing to this age group, but Ronald Reagan is the president of the United States. But 8, I'm going to go higher. I'm going to go with it. I'm going to say higher.
Higher than 8. This is interesting here. The actual number of these boys who would rather meet Michael Jackson is 1. 1. It isn't higher. It is lower. 1. Hey, which one of you guys would rather meet Michael Jackson? Here he is. Hey, listen, you're entitled to your opinion. You're all right. We're not going to arrest you. Don't be sorry. Do not be sorry. Listen, thank you again, fellas. Go ahead. Have a seat right now. Way to go. Katrina, here's that 10.
You know, I would like to change that number, please.
Okay. You can change that 10. Here it is. It's an 8. Oh, okay. Right in the middle here.
Higher.
She's going higher than an 8.
Lower
than a jack.
Yes.
If she's right, she wins game number 1. Lower than a jack. A jack.
No,
not lower. We go back to the 8, and Clay gets a free shot at the cards. Clay, let's take a look at this. You're playing from a 7.
I'll work lower off that 7.
Lower on the 7. We've got a jack. It is not lower than the 7. So we go on to our third question, and this one is for you, Clay. We surveyed 100 men, and we asked them, have you ever backed down from a fist fight because the other guy was just too big? How many men admitted they have backed down from a fist fight because the other guy was too big?
I just can't imagine too many people besides Billy Martin not backing down from a fight because he was too big. I think, could you repeat the question one more time? I'm not sure. How many did back down?
How many men admitted they have backed down from a fist fight because the other guy was too big?
A very high number, 74.
74.
Right.
74. What do you think, Katrina? High or low?
Okay, I think that number's going to be a little bit lower because some men like the challenge and they don't want to be called cowards. So that number's going to be just a little lower.
You're going a little bit lower.
Yes.
The actual number of men who have backed down from a fist fight is 36. It is lower.
All right.
Lady knows it. Katrina, how about this 8?
No, change that number, please.
Going to change that 8?
Yes.
To a 4.
Higher.
Good. Higher than a 4. A king. Lower. This is for game number 1. It is lower. Wonderful play. Excellent. Congratulations, you won $100 for game number 1. Whoever wins 2 games, they go on to the money cards. We're going on right now. Suzanne is going to be dealing out the cards. Let's get on to our second game, Clay. This is a must-win situation for you. You got to stay in here if you want to get a shot at those money cards. Here is our first question, and this one goes to you, Katrina. We surveyed 100 women who are newlyweds, and we asked them, was your honeymoon night a disappointment? How many newlywed women said, yes, it was a disappointment?
That number is going to be very low, because the honeymoon night is the greatest night. Okay, and I'm going to say that number is approximately 22.
Higher number than that. I don't think that your honeymoon's going to be very memorable. I'll say higher than 22.
Higher than 22?
Correct.
The actual number of newlywed women who said their honeymoon was a disappointment is 23. It is higher, but just by 1. Good situation. The play goes to the cards first here. Let's take a look at the card.
It's a 9.
I'd like to change that 9, please.
So change that 9. The 9 now becomes a 4.
Go higher than a 4.
Higher than a 4. Oh, a deuce. Katrina, you got a free shot of the cards here. Let's take a look at it. I'm playing off the 5.
Higher!
Higher than a 5. A king.
Lower!
Lower than a king. A 5. Higher than a 5. An 8.
Freeze!
You got a
freeze.
I thought you were going to go for it. I could see that look in your eye. We're going to be back with more card sharks right after this commercial message. We've run out of time. We've just enough time to say goodbye. We'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
Some of our departing contestants will receive the Polaroid Spectra System camera with computer-designed exterior, autofocus, and audio signal system. Beautiful pictures instantly and automatically furnished by Polaroid. A Harvest Saver dehydrator preserves delicious fruits and vegetables, makes rich, creamy yogurt, grows salad sprouts, and makes fruit roll-ups furnished by Harvest Saver. Double the storage space throughout your whole house with closet-made instant organizers and ventilated drawer systems from Clairson International. An alarm clock, an Alba 77 high-calcium shakes, just 70 calories, and more calcium than 8 ounces of milk. Alba, so yummy and delicious, it's calcium. A sports watch, and there's nothing like coming home to the delicious homemade taste of Ragu spaghetti sauce. Ragu, that's Italian. A calculator and fast, effective mutex remover. It actually locks in moisture, so your nails get stronger every time you use it. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Shark. A Mark Goodson Television Production.